Whether it's coming home or not, I'm not sure. But we have to wait till the grand finale of Euro 2020. But, England are definitely coming home because they have won in Rome and now the semi-finals are in Wembley. They will be taking on Denmark. And everybody knows how good England defense has been. No competition to England's defense. But today I'll be talking about four different players who were under fire, under pressure, and were outstanding against Ukraine and helped them reach the semi-final. See, when the defense is so good, that's why you don't concede in the first five matches of Euros. No team has ever done that, not conceding in the first five games. And you can hardly remember Jordan Henderson making a great save all throughout the tournament, barring one or two here and there. But that will be another discussion. Today's point is the four players who were tremendously under pressure. First of all, Raheem Sterling. Manchester City this season, he didn't get that many games, was totally under pressure for missing goals. When he came to England, he was constantly under pressure. People were questioning whether Calvert-Lewin, whether other players should be brought in place of Raheem Sterling. And look how beautifully he has turned it around. Today also, he gave a brilliant pass by getting past players and giving a through ball to Harry Kane for that opening goal. Brilliant goal, three goals, one assist in the tournament. Next up, who is it? It's the one who scored from Raheem Sterling's pass, that's Harry Kane. The last part of the season for Tottenham was not that great. This tournament, when he came in, he was not finding the target, even struggling to register shots on goal, and even looked a little bit jittery. His fitness was being questioned. People were again asking whether Harry Kane is just filling up the numbers. Was England playing with 10 men? And look how he has turned it around in the last two games. Brilliant runs, brilliant goals, two goals in this game. One with that Raheem Sterling through ball, the other one with a brilliant cross from Luke Shaw. And then there was a beautiful volley, which the goalkeeper, Ukraine goalkeeper Buschan, just kept outside. I think that was the shot of the evening. So Harry Kane was the other one. Who is the third one? Jordan Henderson, England's star-studded, experienced player, Liverpool's captain, again with Liverpool not performing that well and his own form also not that great this season. Again, a player who was in this team with a little bit of injury worries, questioned a lot whether he should have been taken in this team or not, whether he is taking up a place in the team. But Jordan Henderson, one more thing, just before the start of Euros in the friendlies, one of the friendlies, he took a penalty himself without allowing his teammate to take it and missed it. He couldn't get his first national goal at that occasion and he was constantly criticized that whether he was being taken because he is a big name in Liverpool or not. But what a great header from a Mason Mount corner. And that was the fourth goal for England. By that time, the match was well and truly over, but you could look at the celebration which Jordan Henderson did. He was overjoyed and that's what you need in this time because he's a brilliant player who will get a lot of confidence after this performance and he can already back up because Declan Rice is playing well. He can already be as a good backup because he might not start, but with this performance, he will be ready for any situation. The last name who isn't under fire for media or fans or anybody, but under fire from a special one. Who is it? Jose Mourinho. I think Jose Mourinho always tries to keep Luke Shaw under pressure, under fire. Remember the days, Manchester United days, he suffered a leg break, horrific, and then he was mentally really harassed by Jose Mourinho. And there was a point of time he was totally criticized day in, day out, but Mourinho, but how brilliantly he came back for Manchester United, has been a consistent performer. And this season, oh my god, that runs around that left hand side, left wing, with linking up with players like Raheem Sterling, Grealish and all those players. And today he showed his brilliant side again with a beautiful free kick. He got Harry Maguire to score, and then with a beautiful cross, Harry Kane scored. So two brilliant assists, was very good with the dribbles, won most of the tackles and was brilliant in his effort. So Luke Shaw is the other one who was brilliant. Four players under fire, under pressure, but gave their best. England also doing their best at the later stages of the tournament. Everything coming good for England. Can they beat Denmark? Denmark, the only team, the last team who beat them in Wembley. England, can they overcome Denmark? We'll talk about that. I'll predict that game later on. But if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and also please hit the bell icon for all notifications. For now, bye bye.